Welcome back. It's that time. We join Mike Eppel. Happy Monday, Mike. How are you?
Thank you. I'm good. Thank you. How are you?
I'm doing all right. Okay, so I'm looking at this email sent from you, and I can't believe it. We're almost done the first half of the year. 2021?
Three more days. Three more days.
Such a blur this year.
July 1st, and, well, I think Friday was 6 months to Christmas.
Don't you even do that. Don't play that game. Yeah. All right.
Hey, listen, yes, the time is of the essence, I suppose, or our enemy or our friend, depending on how you look at it. But for the markets this year, Melanie, it has been terrific. You know, the TSX is up close to 16% first half of the year. The Dow's up 13%. A lot of analysts at the start of the year said, whoa, this year is just going to be mediocre at best, and people have to be cautious, and all the stock markets have done is go up and up and up. So it's YOLO, FOMO, or whatever other acronym you want to fit in here. But interest rates are still record lows. Central banks haven't changed policy. Earnings have been good, and that's a key contributor here as well. Got to keep that in mind. And because at the end of the day, it is about the earnings, regardless of what the Wall Street bets and meme stocks and Reddit and all that, all those players want to tell you. We're also looking at the price for oil this morning, north of $74 per barrel, with an OPEC meeting on the agenda again this week. And oil has been the best performing asset class of 2021, up more than 40% since the start of the year. You know, last year you couldn't give it away. This year, oil is getting more expensive as the global economy reopens.
And as we look to the reopening, things slowly getting back to normal, people going back to the office, or are they, or are employers saying, all right, what do we do with people who don't want to come back?
Yeah, it depends on the company. In the U.S. right now, the big investment banks are telling their employees on Wall Street, come back to the office. J.P. Morgan, Morgan Stanley, all of them say, yep, you got to come back in. UBS out of Switzerland this morning saying, nope, they're going the other direction. Two-thirds of their employees can stay from a work-from-home or hybrid model. And this is going to be the push-pull for the labor market, I'm thinking, because in April, for example, 4 million Americans quit their jobs. They've got a labor shortage. Some companies can't find enough employees in the U.S. because people want, they want to be happy. And they're saying, is my job making me happy? Do I have flexibility? You know, what has the pandemic has been a big reset for many from an employment standpoint. So this is going to be this work that companies are going to have to work through to keep their employees happy, or you could see a lot of people changing jobs.
Yeah, to keep your top talent, make them happy, but find the compromise somewhere. This is going to be, you know, I feel like we're going to be dealing with this one for some time.
Oh, yeah, of course. It happened pretty quickly, but at the same time, the aftermath of everything will take time to figure out. And I think we've figured out that work from home actually does work for the most part from a technical standpoint. Sure, you want to come into the office once in a while for the collaborative effort with your employees and coworkers and such. But I think a lot of people are going to choose to not do the commute.
Okay, and to go to infinity and beyond. You know where I'm going with this, Mike?
Yes, indeed. Virgin Galactic, Richard Branson's space exploration company, on Friday got the green light by the U.S. transportation regulator to fly passengers to space. So, yeah, you ready to go to the moon? Well, not quite, but into orbit at least, on the space plane that Virgin Galactic's building and has been test flying, and Jeff Bezos and his brother Mark are going to go up in a test flight on Blue Origin. That's Amazon's space exploration division next month. And of course, Elon Musk's SpaceX. Virgin Galactic on Friday, Melanie, went up by 39%. It's gone up 200 and some odd percent over the past year, and got a big booster rocket for its share price from that FAA announcement.
Wow. Okay, we've got about 15 seconds left, Mike. Mm-hmm. Big box office. What are you seeing?
F9, the latest Fast and Furious movie. I saw Hobbs and Shaw, was that Calvin and Hobbs. I'm not sure which.
Oh, boy.
Anyway, this one brought in, it was a good movie, actually, with Jason Statham and The Rock. Anyway, this version brought in $70 million at the box office, and that's the biggest opening weekend for a movie since 2019's Star Wars The Last Skywalker. Of course, here in Ontario, the theaters are still closed, Melanie, but I went, drove past the drive-in up in Lindsay, Ontario, and huge lineups for this movie on Saturday night.
Well, it's what you can do, right?
You drive to the drive-in, and then you do not break the rules of the road just because you watched F9.
Yes, yes, yes. Please, please obey the rules. Stephanie Henry right now is shaking her finger. All right, as always, a pleasure, Mike. We'll talk to you tomorrow.
See ya.
619 is your time right now. Coming up next, COVID-19 cases dropping across our province, but one region outside of the GTA still seeing high numbers here. We're going to break that all down for you. Up next.